Very good morning to all. Myself Dr. Ansar Ahmed, and in this lecture I am going to explain RS flip-flop. As you know, in the previous lecture I discussed about latch and the difference between the flip-flop and latch. Let's recall what is flip-flop. In sequential circuit, a storage device or memory is required to know what exactly has happened in the past, because sequential circuit are those circuit in which output depends on the present input as well as previous output. Okay, so what happened in the previous, we need to store that data or that output, and for that one we need memory. The basic unit of such storage device is known as the flip-flop. Okay, so this is flip-flop. A flip-flop is a memory device that has clock signal to change or control the state of the device. As we have seen in the difference between the flip-flop and latch, that is flip-flop has clock and latches does not have clock. This is a major difference between the flip-flop and RS latch. So this was the definition of flip-flop. Flip-flop are actually an application of logic gates. Flip-flop can also be considered as the most basic idea of random access memory, as you know that it works as a memory. A higher application of flip-flop is helpful in designing the better electronic circuits. So whatever electronics, high-end circuits we have, we use flip-flop to design those circuits. The most commonly used application of flip-flop is in the implementation of a feedback circuit. And feedback circuit is important because somewhere we need to control the things just observing the previous condition. Or suppose we want to improve the quality of any thing, then without knowing the previous history we cannot improve. So feedback is important in many places. There may be numerous applications of the domain to apply that flip-flop. As a memory relies on the feedback concept, flip-flop can be used to design them. Okay. Now, types of flip-flop. There are four basic types of flip-flop. First one is SR or RS flip-flop, JK flip-flop, D flip-flop, T flip-flop. So we will discuss one by one what is SR flip-flop, what is JK flip-flop, what is D flip-flop and what is T flip-flop. So first of all, SR flip-flop. What is SR flip-flop? That is set and reset flip-flop. Set and reset. In the reset, the output is zero. Whatever outputs you have, it will be zero. And set, that is Q, is equal to 1 or high. So whatever previous output you have, whether 0 or 1, it will be 1, and in reset it will be opposite. So clock SR flip-flop, because it contains a clock. Actually SR flip-flop is the combination of latch and clocked. A clocked SR flip-flop is designed by adding two AND gates to a basic NOR SR latch or NAND gate with NAND based SR latch. So a clocked SR flip-flop can be designed with the two AND gates with SR NOR SR latch or NAND SR latch, or it can be implemented with the help of NAND NAND gate and NOR SR latch or NAND SR latch. So there may be many combination of clock SR flip-flop. Here we are using AND gate 1 and 2 on which we are applying clock. This is a clock. and these are the SR flip-flop. So these SR flip-flop may be no NOR gate, NOR SR flip-flop or NAND SR flip-flop, and we are having two outputs which are opposite or inverted to each other. How this works, let's find out. So if we see that one, this is SR latch. This SR latch, basically, and this portion that is we are adding, this is the clock. Okay. So how this work and what is the utility of it, we'll see. So here, this diagram we are going to expand here. This is simply one circuit. Okay, this is gate one and this is gate two, and these are the AND gate, and these are the two NOR gate. As we have already explained, if we see, we observe that this section is the SR latch, SR NOR latch. Okay, NOR latch. Just see, we have already discussed about SR NOR latch. Now it is clocked, or clock is applied with the help of two AND gates. So it may be here NAND भी हो सकता है, यहाँ पे आपके NOR भी हो सकता है, depends upon you. But you know the basic of this thing. Then working of clocked SR flip flop. Working of clocked SR flip flop. So we can see that this is clock. When the clock is zero, and this is zero, so this will be zero, this will be also zero, and if we apply zero here or one here, it does not matter. Just see what will be the output. If any input of AND gate is zero, then output will be zero. Okay, if any input, see, this is the AND gate. So what is AND gate? This is A, this is B, and this is A B. So if this is zero, this is zero, and this is one, then this will be equal to, this is equal to one, this is zero. So any input of AND gate gives the output zero. So in that case there'll be zero output. Fine. So let's see, when the clock is low, that is zero, the output of two input AND gates will be zero for any input of SNR. The zero input to the RS flip-flop with NOR gate result is no change state. Okay, so no change state at the output. This ensures for the clock zero or low condition, the output will remain in the same state. And how this is, we have explained. Now I'm coming back on this one. If this is zero and this is zero, so let's find out the truth table of SR latch. This is the truth table of SR latch. Okay, do you remember? This is the SR latch. And when we are having S is equal to zero, R is equal to zero, then we got, that is the next state. क्या मिलेगी आपको? Qn and Qn dash. That is the, there will be no change. That is, this is the memory state. Okay, whatever value you have, it will be same. So at this one, if this is zero, then whatever the value of second input, it does not matter. Suppose Q is equal to 0. Okay, suppose Q is equal to 0, then this Q 0, that is 0 will be here. Okay, then output will be 1. Okay, and suppose if this is this is 1 and this is 1, output is 1, then it will be 0. Already we explained the truth table of NOR SR latch. So there should not be any point. If you are not knowing it, please go back to SR latch and then try to get it. So if the input of any NOR SR latch is 0, 0, any input of SR latch is 0, then output will be in previous state. There is no change. So this is no change. Okay. Now let's see other thing. When the clock is high, now this is high. This is high. Okay, that is here we will have 1, and here we will have 1. Then this will be 0. This will be 0 condition. That is next conditions. So what will be there again? What will be the condition? That is you will have 0, and this will be 0, because we are having the previous state, that is R is equal to 0, S is equal to 0, the output will be in the same conditions. Okay, in the no change condition, even we have applied the, so this one. Okay, so first condition is when clock is 0, then Q is equal to no change and Q bar is equal to no, that is output will be. Okay, so in that condition, if the clock is 0, so S is equal to 0 or 1, it does not matter. But 0 or 1, value of SR is equal to 0 or 1 does not matter. There will be no change. So when we apply clock 1 and if there is 0, 0, again the condition will be no change. Okay, so both conditions satisfy this one. Now let's get our next conditions. Next condition is this one. Suppose this is 0, this is 1, this is 1. Okay, and next R is equal to, next is this one, S is equal to 0 and R is equal to 1, S is equal to 0 and R is equal to 1. Okay, so let's see, this is 1, this is 1. Okay, ye 1 0 hua aur ye aapka kya hua, 1 1 hua. So if the 1 1, that is the output of the AND gate will be 1. Okay, and the output of this gate, that is 1 and 0, so 1 and 0, that is 0. So this is the combination of 1 0. So here what will happen 1 0 ke liye, just find out 0 1 ke liye aapka kya hoga, Q is equal to 0 and Q n plus bar is equal to 1, that is condition will be reset. Okay, so Q is equal to 0. So this is the next condition. When clock is equal to 1, S is equal to 0, R is equal to 1, then circuit will be reset, that is output will be changed. Okay, output will be changed from 0 to 1 or 1 to 0, that it will be 0. Now next conditions, let's find out. This is 1 0. Okay, this is 1, S is equal to 1 and R is equal to 0. So put here, S is equal to 1, S is equal to 1 and R is equal to 0. Okay, and the clock is high, that is 1. So this one, 0 1, that is output will be 0. and this is 1 clock is high, and this is also 1, s is equal to 1, so output will be 1. Now the condition is 0 1, okay. Then in for that one, the q will be just see here, q will be in this way, that is set ho jayega aapka, q will be 1 and q bar will be 0, that is set ho jayega, okay. Tab aapka output will be, that is at 1 0, when s is equal to 0, r is equal to 1, then the output will be 1 0. So it will set the output. Okay, we have explained this thing. I am saying again, if you are not knowing what how I am making the truth table, please just watch out the previous or the SR latch video. Okay, now next condition, when the SR, that is this one, clock is high, and s is equal to 1, and r is equal to 1 also, so this is 1 into 1 is equal to 1, and this is 1, fine. And just see, this is the SR latch table, when s is equal to 1, r is equal to 1, then the output is invalid, okay. So the output will be invalid, fine. So this is the SR flip flop. So it is simple to analyze after the clock. So you will say, sir, what is the advantage of SR flip flop, or what is the difference between the SR flip flop? So guys, it is just like controlling the inputs or controlling the circuit. When there is no clock, there will be no change in the state, that is circuit will be remain in the previous state or in the memory state. So there are a lot of applications where we can use the previous state as the again and again, okay. Similarly, when we want to change the output, then we need to apply the clock. So this is the basic difference. That's why this circuit is called the SR latch, or this is also called gated flip-flop. These are called gated flip-flop. Why gated flip-flop? Because this clock control the latch or the NOR latch or NAND latch or the circuits. Whatever circuits you are having here, it is controlled by that gate, that is by this clock pulse. So this is the only difference, that SR flip-flops are controlled by the clock. If there'll be no clock, then circuit will be in memory state or the previous state or no change state. And when we are going to apply the clock, then obviously it will change its state as per the combinations or inputs of the SR. When the value of the SR will be, that is no change, and when the value of S is equal to 0, R is equal to 0, then the circuit will be set. ये यहाँ पे आपका रिसेट हो जाएगा, दैट इज रिसेट, ओके. व्हेन द एस इज इक्वल टू 1 एंड आर इज इक्वल टू 0, देन इट विल बी सेट, फाइन. सो इट इज द कंट्रोल सर्किट वी गेट. दिस इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द एसआर लैच एंड एसआर फ्लिप फ्लॉप. सो गाइस, इट वाज ऑल अबाउट द एसआर फ्लिप फ्लॉप. आई होप यू गॉट इट. In the next one, we will discuss some other part of SR flip-flop. Till then, take care and have a great time.